Hi guys, and welcome to another video. Now, before we get stuck into this pile, there's a few things that I've got to go through. One of which is a message for no privacy. When you're leaving a comment, I'm getting a notification to say you've left one, but I can't find the actual comment itself. This has happened a few times now. It's not in the awaiting moderation pile. It's not anywhere. I just don't know where it's gone. I can't see it. Now, I've pretty much done all I can, which is send feedback to YouTube and say, hey folks, comment being left, here's the notification, where's the comment? But yeah, so I'm out of options on that one. I don't know what's going on. The next one is, if you're following the game videos, you'll notice one in which I talk a bit about Brexit and Spain, Gibraltar, the EU, and all of that jazz. And because I'm... yeah, it's a delicate subject, a detailed one with a lot of depth to it. And I'm also trying to talk about it when I'm playing a game. It wasn't the best way of going about it. So when you see it, if you see it, I thought I'd better explain myself now. If you wait for a few sections, I basically start off and it appears like it's going one way, and then I get involved in something before I can finish it off, but then I finish off the explanation further on down the video. And what it is this. In the ongoing Brexit hoo-ha, there's many other things that's going to come out of the woodwork. One of which is that I think the rest of the EU is going to see what the EU itself, or rather the politics, has become. Now, in the divorce process, it requires pretty much 100% agreement from all the various other countries that are involved in order for things to keep progressing. Now, there's various things all over history in terms of different countries, borders, wars, in effect, that the UK has been pretty much out of that, or out of a good portion of it, purely due to the UK being an island. But there were a few things that we were in the middle of, and one of those was Gibraltar. Now, in amongst all the various political rhetoric that's being thrown around, Spain, well, if you want to look into the history of Gibraltar and how it all happened, please look it up, because it's far deeper than what I'm explaining here. And indeed, I'm just cutting a very, very complicated situation very short. A few hundred years ago, basically, Gibraltar was handed over to UK for governance. We're now in the and since for quite some time, Spain has wanted it back. It's similar to the ongoing thing with Argentina and the Falkland Islands. Long-running situation. It's another one of those situations that's sort of akin to, the argument with getting rid of time-saving in the UK. You know, until there is always a crowd of people that's pushing to get rid of the time saving, and they will continue to push forever and more until they get their way. And that's just the way things are, and that's the way the argument is going to be. That's just one of those things you've got to accept. There are various people that feel various ways about various things, and they will continue to push for what they want and what they see is right. And that's just the way life is. The UK has always gone, well, typically, among self-determination of the populace. And that's been the thing that keeps cropping up. Spain has, to a degree, been relatively silent-ish. or rather, had issues with, or not been able to push as hard as it would like on the issue of Gibraltar, because of everything being in the EU. And now that the UK is coming out of the EU, Spain sees that as the justification to go further. The very long story, very short on this, is that Spain is basically threatening to throw a spanner in the works on any deal unless it gets Gibraltar, or unless I don't know the whole details. All we saw in the UK was basically the headline. And as typical with the press these days, we get the biased headline. So we've pretty much only got one side of the story, and it's the story which is pretty much most likely to set hairs running against amongst the UK populace, sort of designed to say to get us saying, "Oh, these Spanish, how dare they? What? You know, all this stuff is just, you know, and because the UK press is pretty much all we've got on this so far, I've only got one side of the story, and even, you know, I'm very aware that I'm not aware. You know, I'm very aware of what I'm being fed, and that I don't really know what's going on the ground. But this and other things are what threatens to not only derail the whole process. I mean, I really think that in about 2 years, there's going to be so much infighting and lack of agreement within the EU politicians that Britain is just going to end up saying, "Well, if you guys can't come to an agreement, we're off, goodbye." I think that if that happens, and it's looking to me like that's what's going to happen, then it will end up, you know, I think most of the population of Europe will then come to wake up and see what the politics of Europe has become. It's become so mired in so many different countries with so many different populaces with different viewpoints on things and different ways that they want things to go, that reaching agreement on various bits and pieces like this is impossible. And I really do think that it is likely to that is probably what's going to trigger unease in other populations in other EU countries, and is going to potentially lead to the destabilization of Europe as a political entity. In other words, this is only just beginning. This is only just beginning. It's a very sad thing to if it goes this way, but honestly, it's the only way that I can see this actually playing out. Unless something can be done in order to make this relatively smooth, and by relatively smooth, I'm talking 2 to 5 years. The longer that the Brexit issue runs on for, the more damage is going to be done to EU politics. So, yeah, it's a case of sit back with a very big bag of popcorn and watch this one run, because this one is going to unfold. So if you happen to watch that video and you see me go off on a bit of a blather, it's my fault for trying to go into that sort of subject and play a game at the same time. It didn't work. So I don't know what the hell I'm going to do. But anyway, to these, I've got a few bits and pieces at different lengths of these, but they are piggyback cables. I'll just rip one out of its package for you. So many different bits and pieces, and what am I going to use? Oh, the knife was recently sharpened. We did that. So hopefully it will be able to just slice through this, will it? Yes. It's good to have the old knife back. So that was sharpened. But what this is which end did I cut? That one. Come on. It's designed to go in the way of a phono connection for the audio. And it piggybacks a signal off to another set of cables. And this is going to be used for some of the projects that are in here. And I got a few of a different length because I do know that I go through these. I have various uses for them at different points. But they can be, they're very useful, I find, because they can get rid of some of the other more clunky adapters and splices that are going around. So I find them very useful. And there's a whole load of different lengths here. There's two more that are needed. But those will be used in some of the other projects, as you will see. Now, the four projects have landed. On top of that, the 500 resistors are here, but not the project boards yet. So I don't know where the hell they are. When it comes to the USB adapter, the USB sockets are here, so they've arrived. So I can carry on with that project. What else has arrived? Bits and pieces all over the place. Now, we have two clocks. The previous clock that I built has been resent, and yes, it does have both chips. And the one that I built and buggered up completely, so that's here. And we still have, as you've seen before, the more complex digital clock kit. I nearly said something else there without the L, but there you go. So those two are here, and it's going to be an interesting one to go through them again. But before going on to that one, what I thought was I would get involved in some of the spectrum analyzers. This is a more complex spectrum analyzer, and this is supposed to be a straightforward one. I thought, I know. I bought them both at the same time from the same seller, and I thought, I know. I'll start with a nice easy one, and before I go on to the big guy, because this is about a tenner. This is about more than £40 worth. So, yeah, I wanted to try things out. And actually, I think I may have bollocked up. Oh, no, I haven't. Yeah, the LEDs are in there, I think. This one, the more expensive kit, comes what looks like to be quite nice. You have the power cable and the rest of that jazz there. You have some bits and pieces. You also have LEDs. You have a large strip of what I'm assuming are blue, a few of green, and I don't know what the hell they are. I have noticed that there's a little green dot on here, but yeah, all the odds and sods to come with it, and also some comprehensive instructions as to what the hell's going on. the front and the back, yeah, not that comprehensive, unfortunately. All the various bits and pieces, as you typically get. U1, U2, yada yada, blah blah. And 240 LEDs, which are all going to have to be soldered in. And 96 LEDs of another colour all have to be soldered in. Wonderful. So that's going to be nice and complex. Ugh. And they've all got to be soldered onto this. Yeah. So I thought, I know, I'd get myself one of the easier kits in order to bugger it up and learn what the hell I'm doing before I waste 40 plus pounds of, that's pound as in UK money, pound, Great British pound, on this one. So, I bought them both at the same time from the same seller. So they're both on the same eBay transaction, and that is partially what got me unstuck, because, yeah, let's get that out of the way. I thought, okay, but as you can see, there's bugger all in the way here of instructions. There's no instructions. Also, the bag at the bottom actually burst, and all these nuts and screws just fell out all over the place. So it was a complete balls up, and I hope that I've got them all, but here is the, you know, they just go all over the place at a moment's notice. Here's the project board itself. There is a chip already soldered on, and the surface mount. I thought, oh my god, how the hell am I going to do this? So it's obviously going to be the fine-tipped soldering iron for these. There's four resistors, there's nine resistors, I think, and then you've got the LEDs here. You've also got in here the various laser cut sheets, what I want to do is try and get these sheets the hell out of here, so I can hopefully then sort these out. Now, if I'm short here, now I tried to contact the seller and said, hey guys, look, the bag was broken. Obviously, I've put some Sellotape off the bottom of it. How do I get hold of some spare nuts? And by the way, there's no instructions in here. And they guided me to the eBay listing, which said, no instructions. So I was immediately bit my bottom lip and thought, and yeah, so that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's 10 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shit. I am one nut short. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I'm short a nut. Balls. Right, so that's not boding well for this project before we even bloody start. Well, one thing I'm going to do is get a small bag and put these in there out of the sodding way. And I'm going to have to go to the place where I was when I opened this. Oh, fuck's sake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I think I must have just dropped one of these as well. I think I counted 16 originally. Let's just make sure what the hell is in here. Ah, oh, damn it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Damn it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Is that 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm missing one bolt before I start. And I'm missing God knows how many nuts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. Actually, I'm not missing that many. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. One, two, three, four, no, three, four, five. So that makes 10. That makes 13. So I'm missing, I've dropped one bolt and two nuts. Where the fuck have they gone? Well, there's the bolt. So I now have 16 bolts, but I am missing three nuts, two of which are here, one of which is God knows where that is. What the hell's that? That's a piece of sodding solder. Absolutely useless to me. What else do we have around here? Okay. Hopefully these are magnetic. Somewhere around here I have this. Are they magnetic? Yes, they are. Oh, shit. Yes, they are. Fuck. Let go. Quick sweep. And what do we have? Oh, a load of bits that I cut off. Various odds and sods. Anything else? Well, it looks like I'm going to have to go on an expedition to hunt these things down. Right, that wasn't very clever of me, was it? No, I'm now going to have to hunt those things down because they could be any bleeding where. They literally could be anywhere. Right. So, the only saving grace that I have really is a picture from the eBay site, which actually shows that. And by enlarging it, I'm hopefully going to get a bit of an idea as to what the hell I'm doing. Because other than that, I'm pretty much winging it. Huff. Yeah, very much winging it. Now I've got to find these bloody nuts. Wish me luck. Bye for now.